My name is Jill Powell. I'm a celebrity makeup artist.
There's an S under my clothes. On my chest where nobody.
I am going to be showing you guys today a tutorial on creating Demi Lovato's red lipstick Hollywood glamour look for Coco Perez. You want to make sure that your red lipstick stays all day. So I love using a lip primer. This one's by Too Faced. You can also use some eyeshadow primers are okay for the lips, but I do prefer this one. It's just a clear solution, and you just put it on, and once it sets, it really ensures that your lip color stays. You want to make sure that the lip liner is nicely sharpened, and also I'm using more of a blue-based red. This gives a really clean, clean lip line, and I like to start right at the base of the lip. Kind of getting your shape right at the bottom because this is really important to keep everything centered and clean. You want to make sure the top of your lip line is nice and symmetrical. So starting in the Cupid's bow, I like to create my shape by holding the pencil at a slight angle and getting the base of your Cupid's bow perfected before continuing on. A great tip if you want to make your top lip line look more voluptuous is to actually start in the corner and then connect upwards towards the Cupid's bow. When you do that, you're actually creating more volume and a more rounded lip shape. So I'm taking a lip brush and getting the lipstick on both sides of the lip brush. So I'm starting in the center and I'm just gonna paint this on back and forth. And I find that when you use a lip brush, it's actually working the lipstick into your lips and again will help with the longevity of the lipstick wearing throughout the day. And then go ahead and press your lips together for me. You want to give your lips a nice press, and then I'm going to teach you a few things how to make it look really crisp and again stay all day. So what I like to do is take either a small angle brush or a brush with just a really clean edge to it, again with that drier consistency concealer, and go right along the edges. So if you come right here, so you have a little bit of concealer on the brush, you don't need a lot. And then just right next to the lip line, you clean it up. So lay it right along the skin, and then just clean it up. And then once you've done that, take your flat concealer brush, and you can just, again, blend that so that it doesn't look like too strong of a line. And once you have that perfect red lip, you want to make sure that it stays in place. So go ahead and use a loose powder. And I'm just using kind of like a fluffier brush, and then you just want to pat it onto the lip. So you don't need that much, but what it's going to do is it's going to set your lip and make sure that it stays. So once you have the lip in place, you can go ahead and finish the rest of your face to make sure that it supports your red lip. With Megan here, I'm just going to place the brush there and gently sweep it towards the center. Remember, where you place the brush first is where the most color gets concentrated, so that's why I don't like to place the brush here first and go back, because you'll be left with a big blob right there, and that's not cute. So getting it right underneath her cheekbone to the corner of the lip, and then you can also blend the bronzer up into the hairline, and you can also go right under the jawline and down the neck. One other tip that I do whenever you're taking any type of photos, it's great to contour your nose. You just need a tiny little bit. So again, keeping that same bronzer, I love taking kind of a fluffier brush and then just starting on the edge of the nose and going down, and then same thing on the other side. You're just creating a little bit of a contour along the sides, and then I'll show you in a moment how we highlight the center. Once we've created shape on the face by contouring, I love to create a highlight as well. So a few places that you can highlight is the top of the cheekbone, the bridge of the nose, the Cupid's bow. You can do a little bit on the chin and sometimes right above the brows. It creates such a subtle lit from within look. And in a photo, it actually just really makes your nose look nice and beautiful. You can also take this and kind of go right along the tops of the cheekbones. So again, feel for your cheekbone, and it's that area between the eye area and your cheekbone. And again, using your fingers to blend. The next place you can highlight is right above the Cupid's bow, and this will just make the top lip look a little bit bigger. So I'm taking a pointed brush so I can be a little more specific. And again, using the same cream-based product, you just go right along that edge. And you're not quite on the lip, but you're right above the lip. So last but not least, when we're highlighting, I like to create some glow on Demi's skin. She has such beautiful skin, and everybody's always asking me how I do it. I use a lot of different highlighters, but my ultimate favorite is by Laura Mercier. It's called Spellbound, and it has some gold and some pink and peach in it, so it will complement any skin tone. I like using a smaller fluffy brush, and you just need a little bit of product on it. I always tap off the excess, and then I like to apply this again where we highlighted on the tops of the cheekbones, but I do bring it a little bit towards the center of the cheek as well. And last but not least, to complete our look, you have to add a tiny bit of color to the cheeks just to balance out the color with the rest of the face. One thing to make sure that you remember when you're picking out your blush color is to pay attention to the color of the lipstick. It's important to match the undertone of the lipstick when selecting your blush to make sure that your look stays cohesive. So since she has more of a blue-based lip, I'm gonna choose more of a blue-based blush. And just have your model smile, or you can smile to see where the apples of the cheeks are. And then we're just going to dust right along those apples. And I like to start in the center and move my way outward. And if you notice, I'm holding my brush further back because I want just a very, very soft touch. If you hold it up close, you're gonna get a really heavy hand, and with blush, that's probably not gonna be your best friend. And just smile. And I'm hitting the apples of the cheeks and then brushing outward. So there you have it, a few simple steps to get an old Hollywood glam, beautiful red lip color just like Demi Lovato.